Good afternoon and welcome to Wednesday afternoon devotions for Zion Lutheran Church in Minot. Today will be brief. I just would like to share with you a couple of announcements with you. It's the new year. Hopefully it'll be better than 2020. Let's keep our hopes up. And as we move into the new year, we are adding to our theme of finding hope and promise in Christ. We were, for a few weeks, our theme was finding hope and promise in the Bible. And now that we have come to the new year and Christmas with the birth of Jesus, and we will be now turning to finding hope and promise in Christ. Hashtag not what you expected, Zion. As we explore who Jesus is through the eyes of Luke's gospel, we will find that Jesus is not what people expected. Too often we make Jesus into what suits and justifies our lifestyles. However, Scripture tells us that Jesus does not fit into the status quo and will challenge everyone who encounters to embrace the unexpected. Not what you expected, Zion. So tune in. Pastor John will be leading us on Sunday with a sermon as we start this theme of hashtag not what you expected, Zion. Another announcement is that we are looking, as we go into our new year, and we have some positions to fill on church council and our trust committee. Our nominations committee will be meeting soon. If you know of anyone that their gifts would be suited to being a council member or on our trust committee, please bring those names forward to us, either here on Facebook in the chat box or give the office a call, Pastor John or Karen, and just give us those names. We are looking for 5 trust committee members and 2 council members to be filled this year. So please be discerning that and help us to fill those positions as we see gifts in other people and how they could care to the community of Zion and be in leadership with us. I am going to read from you on Sunday. The sermon was from our bishop, and he read from Luke chapter 2, so this is right after the birth of Jesus, and Jesus is brought to the temple. He is 8 days old. Luke chapter 2, verses 21 through 36. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child, and he was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or 2 young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit, it rested on him. It had been revealed to him by this Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too. There was a prophet, Anna, of the tribe of Asher. She was of great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage. Then, as a widow to the age of 84, she never left the temple, but worshipped there with fasting and prayer, night and day. At that moment, she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for redemption of Jerusalem. I appreciate the characters of Simeon and Anna as they patiently waited for this Messiah, for a sign. And in their waiting, they never said they got angry or impatient. They simply waited and rejoiced when the child, the baby Jesus, was brought to them. I want to end in a word of prayer that goes along with our reading from the Gospel of Luke. Let us pray. Loving God, we bring our world here. For here we need to make sense and seek hope and long for renewal for those who live on the wrong side of hope. We long to wait for justice and promise to happen, for you to do something about it, where the world seems too big for us to sort out. But may our faith be found in how we respond to this new year moment, and let it shape our hope in the fresh view of this new year. May our faith be found in how we respond to those in conflict, how we treat immigrants, how we work for peace here. May our faith be found in how we work for those living under the threat of climate change, how we treat our environment, how we live more sustainably in the world and care for the land. May our faith be found in how we focus on feeding the hungry, the trade rules we support, the balance of power, and the policies of nations, all which affect the hungry. May our faith be found in how we make space for those without shelter, who are lost in the world, who are homeless and unwelcome. May our faith be found in how we respond to the needs of the world this day, this new year beginning, and hear you inviting us to change our lifestyle, to be patient like Simon and Anna, that all might have justice and peace, and make room for prayers to be answered. Hear us as we pray. Amen. Thank you for joining us for these brief announcements and reading and prayer. If you have any names to be brought forward, if you have any prayers to be brought forward, put those in the chat box, and we will continue to pray for you and to lead this congregation in peace and justice and patience. Thank you.